From the previous lecture, we have discussed about the muscles of the eyeball, extraocular muscles of the eyeball, the actions of these muscles, the nerve supply of the muscles, the origin and the course of the muscle, and how will it test these muscles. So now we have antagonistic muscle and synergistic muscle. So two types of muscle are there. Antagonistic muscles are medial rectus and lateral rectus. These are the antagonistic muscle of the same eye. Superior and oblique, inferior oblique muscles of the same eye. Superior rectus, inferior rectus muscles of the same eye are the antagonistic muscle. Synergistic muscle is superior rectus and inferior oblique. These are the synergistic muscles. Inferior rectus and superior oblique. These are the synergistic muscles. Okay, so these are the antagonistic muscles and synergistic muscles. Now coming about the disease known as strabismus or squint, also known as squint. So it is a condition in which one visual axis is towards the fixation object, the other is deviated from the point. So one visual axis is towards the fixation object, the other is deviated from this point. So orthophoria is the ideal condition. Ideal condition which is found is some people, not all the people, but some people it is found. Normal condition in which the eyes are parallel, so without any effort of fusion faculty for distant fixation, and have a proper convergence for the near vision. So this is known as orthophoria. Now what is heterophoria? So strabismus is classified into heterophoria, and that is known as latent squint, and concomitant squint, prominent squint, concomitant squint, and the non-concomitant squint. So what is heterophoria or latent squint? It is basically prevented by the fusion mechanism. It is prevented by fusion mechanism. It can be of esophoria. What is esophoria? If it is right eye, then this is the nasal side, this is the temporal side. So inward deviation of the eye, inward deviation of the eye is known as esophoria. Eso means inward deviation, exophoria means outward deviation, right, towards the temporal side. Esophoria is towards the nasal side, exophoria is towards the temporal side. Esophoria is basically found in the hypermetropic person, exophoria is found in the myopic person or presbyopic person. Hyperphoria is a condition where the eye is tilted upward, upward deviation. So, and cyclophoria is the torsional deviation. But latent squint, why it is latent? Because people is apparently normal. The eyes of the patient is apparently normal. But when we test that eye by any cover, the squinting eye, if you cover the squinting eye, we can see the deviation. As a result, when this squint is known as the latent squint or heterophoria. Now, what are the clinical features of heterophoria? Blurred vision, headache and eye ache, intermittent diplopia, exhaustion of the fusional reserve. So the range of fusion is tested by synoptophore evaluation. Synoptophore evaluation. So what are the diagnosis? We have to do the cover test. So cover is given to the latent squint eye. The latent squint eye, I have to cover the latent squint eye. Suppose this is the latent squint eye. Both are normal apparently. But if we cover this latent squint eye, there will be a deviation. Either this side, or it can be deviated towards this side. When I fix the normal eye to an object, normal eye is fixed to an object, but this eye will be deviated. But when you uncover this, the deviation is normalized. It will come to the normal state. So this is the latent squint. So we have to do the cover test, Maddox-Rawls test, same as that. Some rod, red rods, as even glass rods, and we have to test this in a 30 centimeter distance. Maddox wing is for detect the amount of heterophoria. amount of heterophilia is detected by Maddox Wing. Prism Bergen's test is the strength of the muscle is tested. And range of fusion is tested by cinematographic evaluation. So what are the treatment? So first treatment is the orthophoric exercise. So you have to do orthophoric exercise. We have to do orthophoric exercise. We have to correct this hypermetropia or refractive error correction should be done, or we can use this prism to manage this fusion, prism or synaptophore to manage this diplopia, intermittent diplopia and fusion mechanism. So when there is a fusion, so there will be a deviation. So when the fusion is removed, the deviation is corrected. So we have the range of fusion is tested. So synaptophore evaluation. So by using synaptophore and prism glass, we can manage this. The minimum surgical intervention is required in the heterophoria of the latent squint. So this is all about the latent squint. In the next lecture, I will talk about the concomitant squint and non-concomitant squint. Thank you.